The word computer was originally used to describe those human beings whose job was to perform the repetitive calculations. The machine named computer was evolved to make complex calculations in a faster way. Nowadays, it processes data to produce meaningful information. Calculation is one of the tasks it performs. So, we call it processor or processing machine. A computer is an electronic device which accepts data, performs mathematical and logical operations according to the instructions given to it, and displays the results of these operations. How does a computer work? Data, collection of raw data and program, set of instructions. Input, processing, by computer, storing data for future use. Output, information, processed and organized data. Input, computer accepts input given by the user in two forms, data and instructions. Data are the raw facts that have been collected but not organized. For example, details of loans taken by several people, different amounts on different rate of interest for different period of time. Computer does not have its own brain. Instructions are given to the computer to process data. Program is a set of instructions or commands to perform a series of calculations or other operations on the data to do a particular task. Processing. Some calculations and logical operations are performed on data by executing the program. Instructions given in sequence. This activity is known as processing. Input and output are stored in the computer's memory and can be retrieved at any time. Output. We obtain the final result or meaningful information after processing the data, called output. Normally, it is displayed on the monitor. There are two main parts of a computer system, hardware and software. Hardware. The physical parts of the computer are called hardware. Hardware is any part of a computer that you can see and touch. The computer system includes central processing unit or CPU, display unit or monitor, keyboard, mouse and any other electronic components. Hardware can be classified as central processing unit or CPU, input devices, output devices, storage devices. Central processing unit or CPU. CPU is the most important part of the computer system. It manages all the activities of the computer. All other electronic components are connected to the central processing unit or CPU through wires or cables. The actual processing is done within this unit only. That is why it is called the brain of a computer. It takes input through the keyboard, stores it, does all the processing and calculations, and displays the results on the monitor as per your instructions. Main parts of the CPU. The three main parts of the CPU are memory unit or MU, RAM, random access memory, ROM, read-only memory, control unit or CU, arithmetic logic unit or ALU, memory unit or MU. This is the main memory of the computer and called primary memory or internal memory. It is used directly and accessed by the CPU during processing of data. Primary memory is categorized as RAM and ROM. RAM, random access memory. Random access memory is called volatile as it holds data and instructions temporarily, that is, shortly needed by the CPU. The contents of RAM are lost when you switch off the computer. Data can be both read from and written into random access memory or RAM. ROM, read-only memory. ROM stands for read-only memory, the memory from which we can only read but cannot write on it. Read-only memory is non-volatile. It is permanent in nature. The contents of ROM are not lost even if the power is off. The information that is required to start a computer is stored permanently in such memories during manufacture. ROM chips are not only used in the computer, but also in other electronic items like washing machine and microwave oven. Control unit or CU. This unit controls the operations of all parts of computer, but does not carry out any actual data processing operations. Functions of this unit are: it is responsible for controlling the transfer of data and instructions among other units of a computer. It manages and coordinates all the units of the computer. It obtains the instructions from the memory, interprets them, and directs the operation of the computer. It communicates with input or output devices for transfer of data or results from storage. Arithmetic Logic Unit or ALU. The Arithmetic Logic Unit consists of two sections, namely Arithmetic Section. It performs arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. All complex operations are done by making repetitive use of above operations. Logic Section. It performs logic operations such as comparing, selecting, matching, and merging of data. Input devices. An input device is a hardware that allows you to enter data in the computer. The input device converts the input received from the user into machine-readable format. The two input devices are essential for you to interact with your computer: keyboard and mouse. Many other input devices exist for entering other types of information, such as images, audio, and video. Input devices represent one type of computer peripheral. The other two types are output devices and storage devices. Keyboard. A keyboard is the most fundamental input device for any computer system. A keyboard contains keys for letters, numbers, special characters, as well as keys for specialized tasks such as enter, delete, etc. Mouse. When operating systems started to use graphical user interface or GUI, the mouse was developed as a pointing device. A mouse resides on a flat surface, and by moving the mouse, you can move the pointer on the screen. One or more buttons on the mouse allow you to enter instructions by clicking. Some models also include a wheel for scrolling. Light pen. It looks like a pen. There is a special pad used with this pen. Whatever you write on this pad with this special light pen, that appears on the monitor. The special pad is known as graphic tablet. You can draw also using this pad and pen. In some cases, you can write or draw directly on the monitor screen. Scanner. A scanner takes an image of the page and enables you to save in several forms that a computer can understand. There are software that can convert an image of text into real text that can be edited. Microphone. It is an input device that is used to record our voice and other sounds into a computer. Magnetic Ink Character Reader, MICR. MICR input device is generally used in banks to process large number of checks every day. The bank's code number and check number are printed with a special ink that contains particles of magnetic material that are machine readable. An MICR reads the characters and sends to the computer as input. The main advantages of MICR is that it is fast and less error prone. Optical Mark Reader or OMR. OMR is a special type of optical scanner used to recognize the mark made by a pen or pencil on a specially designed sheet of paper. It is specially used for checking the answer sheets of examinations having multiple choice questions, out of which one answer is to be selected and marked. Barcode Reader. A barcode is a group of vertical lines or data in form of light and dark lines. Barcode reader is a device used for reading barcoded data generally used in the label of goods or books, etc. It scans a barcode image, converts it into an alphanumeric value, which is then fed to the computer to which barcode reader is connected. Output devices. An output device is any peripheral used to display, print, or project the result of processing done by the CPU. There are various devices available to get information from a computer and produce the output. The most common output devices are Monitor. It is the main and essential output device called Visual Display Unit. It forms images from tiny dots called pixels that are arranged in a rectangular form. The smaller the pixels, the better the image clarity or resolution. There are two kinds of viewing screen used for monitors. Cathode ray tube or CRT monitor. Cathode ray tube or CRT monitor uses an electron beam controlled by electromagnetic field on a phosphor-coated screen. Flat panel display monitor. Flat panel display monitors are light in weight, take less space, and have less power consumption. They are divided into two categories. Emissive displays. The emissive displays are devices that convert electrical energy into light. Example are plasma panel and LED, light emitting diode. Non-emissive displays. The non-emissive displays use optical effects to convert sunlight or light from some other source into graphic patterns. Example is LCD or liquid crystal display. Printer. What you see on the monitor can be print on the paper using a printer. A printer produces output on paper which is permanent and can be referred to at any time. The printing can be black and white or colored. The speed of a printer is measured in CPS is equal to characters per second. LPM is equal to lines per minute. PPM is equal to pages per minute. The faster the printing, the more expensive is the printer. Types of printer. Printers use different techniques to print on the paper. There are three kinds of printers available in the market. These are impact printer, inkjet printer, laser printer. Impact printer. This printer prints characters by striking pins against an ink button. Example, in dot matrix printer, each pin makes a dot and dots in combination form a character. These printers are slow and the quality of output is also not very good. Inkjet printer. This printer sprays ink on a sheet of paper to form characters. The quality of printing is medium and better than dot matrix printers. Normally, the inkjet printers come with a capacity of 600 dpi. Inkjet printers are cheaper than laser printers and generally able to print in color also. These printers are generally used in homes. Laser printer. A laser printer deflects laser beams onto a photosensitive surface to print characters with the help of powder ink. These printers generally print at 600 dpi and are capable of printing up to 2400 dpi. Laser printers produce high-quality printouts and have fastest printing speed, but they are expensive, especially color models. Generally, these printers are used in offices and publishing houses for printing. Plotters. Plotters are much like printers and work on very large sheets of paper while maintaining high resolution. They can print on a wide variety of flat materials, including plywood, aluminium, steel sheet, cardboard, and plastic. Speakers. The speakers give you sound output from the computer. Some speakers are built into the computer and some are separate. You can listen to the music as well as enhance your presentation by the use of audio output.